let's see some more problems of determination of dimensional formula. Okay, so this is a problem: find the dimensional formula of charge, electric potential, capacitance and resistance. Okay, so these formulas are given in a question. Okay, so here our concentration is to determine the dimensional formula on a procedure. Okay, so let's take a first quantity is a charge. So charge is a charge, we can write Q is equal to IT. Okay, so SI unit of Q is equal to SI unit of IT. I is current, T is time. So current is a fundamental physical quantity, so its unit is ampere, and time is also a fundamental quantity, so its unit is second. So ampere into second is also called coulomb. Okay, now dimensional formula for Q is, so for ampere both are the fundamental physical quantities, so A we write A, and for second is a unit of time, so we use T, so it is A1 T1. So dimensional formula for charge is A raised to power 1 and T raised to power 1, and its dimensional equation is square bracket Q is equal to A raised to power 1 and T raised to power 1. Okay, now second is electric potential, so SI, so let's see here. So we write SI unit of this electric potential is equal to SI unit of W by Q. So this is a formula for electric potential, W by Q. W is work and Q is charge. So SI unit of W is joule and SI unit of charge is coulomb. Okay. So joule we can write Newton into meter, and coulomb we can write C, capital C. Now this joule upon coulomb is also called volt. So volt is a SI unit of electric potential V. Okay. So let's see here. So now we know that dimensional formula for Newton is M1 L1 T-minus 2. Okay, for meter we write L1 because meter is a SI unit of length. So we write L raised to power 1. So coulomb we already solved A1 T1. Okay, so solve these powers. You will get M1 L raised to power 2, T raised to power minus 3 and A raised to power minus 1. So this is a dimensional formula, and we equate it with physical quantity, we will get the dimensional equation. So this is a dimensional equation. Okay, now let's see next is capacitance. Okay, so for capacitance formula is Q is equal to CV. Okay, so we arrange this equation, so we determine SI unit of C. The SI unit of C is equal to SI unit of Q divided by V. So here Q is a charge and V is a electric potential. Okay, so we know that SI unit of charge is coulomb and SI unit of electric potential is volt, so it is coulomb upon volt. Okay, so we already solved the both of these. Okay, so we write dimensional formula for coulomb is A1 T1, and for volt is M1 L raised to power 2, T raised to power minus 3 and A raised to power minus 1. So solve this. Okay, solve all the powers, you will get M raised to power minus 1, L raised to power minus 2, T raised to power 4 and A raised to power 2. So this is a dimension formula. When we equate with the physical quantity, we will get dimensional equation. Okay, so there is no need to remember the dimensional formula or dimensional equation of every quantity. Okay, you just remember the formula, any formula, any relation for that physical quantity, then you are able to determine the dimensional equation and dimensional formula. Okay, now let's move to a next quantity. So next quantity is resistance. So we know our formula, V is equal to IR. So apply V is equal to IR, then we will get R is equal to V upon I. So then again apply our procedure, SI unit of R is equal to SI unit of V by I. So V is an electric potential, so its unit is volt. I is a current, so its unit is ampere. So it is volt upon ampere, and volt upon ampere is ohm. Okay, it is called ohm. Okay, now we know for volt dimensional formula is M raised to power 1, L raised to power 2, T raised to power minus 3 and A raised to power minus 1. Okay, now ampere is a SI unit of current. Okay, so we use A raised to power 1. So solve again, you will get M raised to power 1, L raised to power 2, T raised to power minus 3 and A raised to power minus 2. So this is a dimensional formula for resistance. Okay, now when you equate it with a physical quantity, you will get a dimensional equation. Okay, Now let's see a next question. Linear momentum, frequency, linear momentum, frequency and pressure. So linear momentum is a product of mass and velocity. Okay, mass and velocity. So SI unit of linear momentum is equal to SI unit of this quantity. So SI unit of mass is kilogram and SI unit of velocity is meter upon second. Okay. Now to determine a dimensional formula for kilogram, kilogram is a SI unit of mass. So we use m raised to power 1. For meter we use l raised to power 1. And second, when you bring it above, second is t raised to power minus 1. So this is a dimensional formula, m raised to power 1, l raised to power 1 and t raised to power minus 1. When we equate it with a physical quantity, we will get a dimensional equation. Okay, so here you can see. So when we equate here, so we'll get this is a dimensional equation for the linear momentum. Now next quantity is frequency. So frequency, formula for frequency is 1 upon time period. Okay, so again write both sides, SI unit of frequency is equal to SI unit of 1 upon time period. So SI unit of time period is second, so SI unit of frequency is 1 upon second. Okay, jo time period hai uski unit hoti hai second. So this is 1 upon second and 1 upon second is we say hertz. Okay, 1 upon second is also hertz. Okay, now for dimensional formula, so dimensional formula, bring it second, for second is SI unit of time. So when we bring it above, it is t raised to power minus 1, then close it in a square bracket. So t raised to power minus 1, this is a dimensional formula. When we equate it with the physical quantity, this is a dimensional equation. Okay, now next is for pressure. So we know that the formula of pressure is force upon area. So SI unit of pressure is equal to SI unit of force upon area. Now SI unit of force is Newton and SI unit of area is meter square. Now again, dimensional formula for Newton is m1 l1 d minus 2 and for meter we write l raised to power 2. Okay, because meter is a SI unit of length, so we write l raised to power 2. Now solve it, you will get m raised to power 1, l raised to power minus 1 and t raised to power minus 2. So this is a dimensional equation for pressure. Okay, now let's see a next question. So in this question we have quantities angular speed, angular acceleration, torque and moment of inertia. The formulas are also given. So first is angular speed. So angular speed is a rate of change in angular displacement. Okay, rate of change in angular displacement is called angular speed. So its formula is omega is equal to delta theta by delta t. Delta theta is a change in angle. Okay, this is called angular displacement. Now when we write its SI unit, so the SI unit of angle is radian. So its SI unit is radian upon second. But when we write its dimensional formula, we take only second. Okay, so for second we use t, and when we bring it above, t raised to power minus 1. So this is a dimensional formula and this is the dimensional equation for angular speed, t raised to power minus 1 square bracket. Now next physical quantity is torque. Torque is a product of force into distance r, okay, or this radius. Okay, so force into radius, so SI unit of force is Newton, we know, and SI unit of radius is meter. So Newton into meter. So Newton m1 l1 t minus 2 is a dimensional formula for force, and for meter l raised to power 1. So by this we will get m1 m raised to power 1, l raised to power 2 and t raised to power minus 2. Okay, so this is the dimensional equation for torque. Let's move to next physical quantity. Next physical quantity is moment of inertia is mr square, product of mass into square of distance. Okay, so for mass SI unit is kilogram and for this distance from the rotational axis r. Okay, so this is also a distance, so we use meter, so meter is square. So for kilogram we use m raised to power 1 and for meter l raised to power 2. So dimensional formula for moment of inertia is m1 m raised to power 1 and l raised to power 2, and dimensional equation, we equate it with the physical quantity, then you will get its dimensional equation. Okay, now let's move to our next So there is our next physical quantities which we want to determine the dimensional formula. So these quantities, electric field, magnetic field and magnetic permeability. So these formulas are already given. Okay, so arrange this equation. So E is equal to F upon Q. So SI unit of E is equal to SI unit of F upon Q. So here F is a force and Q is a charge. So SI unit of force is Newton and SI unit of charge is Coulomb. So SI unit of electric field is Newton divided by Coulomb. So again, dimensional formula for Newton we know and dimensional formula of Coulomb we also know. So write these m1, m raised to power 1, l raised to power 1, t raised to power 1 is 2. Then for this a raised to power 1, t raised to power 1. So all this you will get dimensional formula for electric field m raised to power 1, l raised to power 1, t raised to power minus 3 and a raised to power minus 1. Okay, equate it with the physical quantity, you will get dimensional equation. Okay, now next is magnetic field. So formula is given, so it is easy. Just SI unit of B is equal to SI unit of F divided by QV. Here F is force, Q is charge and V is velocity. So write Newton divided by Coulomb into meter upon second. Okay, so this is a unit, we will get Newton into second divided by Coulomb into meter. Now again we know dimensional formula for Newton, m raised to power 1, l raised to power 1, t raised to power minus 2. For time we get t raised to power 1. Then for this charge we have a raised to power 1, t raised to power 1. Okay, and for meter is the SI unit of length, so we'll write l raised to power 1. So solve this, you will get m raised to power 1, l raised to power 0, t raised to power minus 2, a raised to power minus 1. So this is a dimensional formula for magnetic field. When you equate it with a physical quantity which is a magnetic field, then you will get the dimensional equation. So this is a dimensional equation for magnetic field. Now next physical quantity is permeability. So it is formula is given already in a question, so you just arrange this formula and write this SI unit of mu 0 is equal to SI unit of this quantity. Now B is a magnetic field which we already solved. Okay, now 2 pi is a constant. Okay, so there is no unit and no dimensional formula for any constant and for any ratio. So 2 pi ka kuch nahi, 2 pi ko nahi lenge isme. And okay, there is no unit and no dimensional formula for any constant or a ratio. So a is a distance here, so write for b is a magnetic field. So we already solved it, so write this. Okay, now here you put the values for B, F raised to power 1, L raised to power 0, T raised to power minus 2, okay. Then A raised to power minus 1, L raised to power 1, divided by A raised to power 1. When you solve it, you will get this equation, M raised to power 1, L raised to power 0, T raised to power minus 2, and A raised to power minus 2, okay. So this is a dimensional formula. When you equate it with the physical quantity, you will get the dimensional equation. So this is a dimensional equation. Okay, now let's see a next question. So in this question we need to determine the dimensional formula for electromagnetic dipole. So the equations are given. Okay, formulas are given already. So P and M, so again write SI unit of P is equal to SI unit of this Q into D. Q is charge and D is distance. So for charge we use Coulomb and distance we use unit meter. So Coulomb into meter is a SI unit of electric dipole moment. Now put the value of dimensional formula for Coulomb or charge, it is A1 T1, and for meter is a SI unit of length, so we use L1. So this is a dimensional formula and this is a dimensional equation for a dipole moment. Okay, now next is a magnetic dipole moment. So we have a formula, so apply this formula, write both sides, SI unit of M is equal to SI unit of IA. So I is a current, so SI unit of current is ampere, and this is A is area, SI unit of area is meter square. So SI unit of magnetic dipole moment is ampere into meter square. Now for ampere is a SI unit of current. Okay, so it is a fundamental unit. Okay, so we use a raised to power 1, for this l raised to power 2. So this is a dimensional formula, m raised to power 0, l raised to power 2, t raised to power 0, a raised to power 1. Okay. Now when we write a dimensional equation, equate this quantity with the physical quantity, you will get a dimensional equation. So this is the dimensional equation for the magnetic dipole moment m. Okay. Now let's move to next question. So in next question, it is given that the energy equation is E is equal to hv. So in which h is a Planck constant, so determine the SI unit and dimension of this Planck constant. You will get h is equal to E by nu. Here E is energy and nu is a frequency. Okay, so the SI unit of frequency is 1 upon second. 1 upon time period is a formula, so 1 upon second. And SI unit of energy is joule. Okay. So for joule we write newton into meter. For joule you write newton into meter. Okay. So again we know, that the dimensional formula for newton is the SI unit of force. So dimensional formula for force is m1 l1 t1 s2. Okay. Now meter is the SI unit of length. So we write l raised to power 1. Now this is t raised to power 1. Solve it, we will get m1 l raised to power 2. T raised to power minus 1. So this is the dimensional equation for Planck constant, m raised to power 1, l raised to power 2, and t raised to power minus 1. Okay. Now let's see this question, question number 8. So in question number 8, the quantities given, physical quantities given are specific heat C, coefficient of linear expansion, okay, and the gas constant R. Okay, these formulas are also given already. Okay, so here alpha is a, this is a alpha, okay, make a correction, this is alpha, okay, so this alpha is the coefficient of linear expansion, okay. Now let's see, now you people are able to understand the procedure. So arrange the equation, then write a unit of C is equal to SI of this quantity. Now Q is a heat, so SI unit of heat is joule, SI unit of mass is kilogram, and SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. So joule divided by kilogram into Kelvin is a SI unit of C, specific heat capacity. Now joule we already know, m1 m raised to power 1, l raised to power 2, t raised to power minus 2. Kilogram is a SI unit of mass, so you would use m raised to power 1, and for Kelvin use k raised to power 1. Okay, solve this, you will get this dimensional equation, m raised to power 0, l raised to power 2, t raised to power minus 2, and k raised to power minus 1. Okay. Now move to next. So this is the next alpha. So arrange your equation, and by arranging again write both sides. Okay, both side SI unit of alpha is equal to SI unit of this quantity. So now when you arrange, this is a change in length divided by length. So change in length ke unit ho jayenge meter and divide by meter. So meter se meter isme cancel ho jayega, niche sirf aapko bachega Kelvin. ओके तो ये आ जाएगा 1 अपॉन केल्विन. नीचे सिर्फ आपका चेंज इन टेम्परेचर बचेगा, और टेम्परेचर के एसआई यूनिट क्या होती है, केल्विन होती है. तो ये आ जाएगा 1 अपॉन केल्विन. ओके तो अल्फा जो है उसकी जो एसआई यूनिट होगी वो क्या होगी, 1 अपॉन केल्विन. और जब आप इसका डायमेंशनल फॉर्मूला लिखोगे तो हो जाएगा के रेस टू पावर माइनस 1. ओके और डायमेंशनल इक्वेशन भी के रेस टू पावर माइनस 1. नाउ नेक्स्ट में आपको दिया गया है गैस इक्वेशन, आइडियल गैस इक्वेशन. सो फॉर आइडियल गैस इक्वेशन इज पीवी इज इक्वल टू एनआरटी, जिसमें R जो होता है वो होता है गैस कांस्टेंट. तो R की यूनिट निकालनी है आपको, तो SI यूनिट ऑफ R इज इक्वल टू SI यूनिट ऑफ दिस क्वांटिटी. तो P इज प्रेशर, V इज वॉल्यूम. तो प्रेशर इनटू वॉल्यूम होता है वर्क. ओके, थर्मोडायनेमिक्स में प्रेशर इनटू वॉल्यूम जो होता है उसको वर्क बोला जाता है. वर्क की यूनिट क्या होती है, जूल. ओके तो P इंटू V की जो यूनिट होगी वो क्या होगी, जूल हो जाएगी. यहाँ से N जो होता है मोल. ओके तो मोल लिख दिया, मोल भी फंडामेंटल यूनिट है. ठीक है, नाउ टी इज टेम्परेचर, तो टेम्परेचर के लिए लिख दिया केल्विन. नाउ व्हेन यू सॉल्व इट यू विल गेट दिस एम रेस टू पावर 1, एल रेस टू पावर 2, टी रेस टू पावर माइनस 2, एंड के रेस टू पावर माइनस 1. व्हेन वी यू इक्वेट इट विद द दिस फिजिकल क्वांटिटी यू विल गेट दिस डायमेंशनल इक्वेशन. ओके सो आई होप यू पीपल आर नाउ एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट व्हाट इज अ प्रोसीजर टू डिटरमाइन द डायमेंशनल इक्वेशन. ओके सो I hope this lecture will help you to determine and to learn the procedure to determine the dimensional equation and dimensional formula of a physical quantities. Okay, then if you find any problem, you can ask to me or you can message me in a comment box. Okay, thank you for watching this lecture.